we decided that as a way to honor him, we needed to focus on education. The birth of the Vincent Tshabalala Education Trust came as a result of paying tribute to him.
Vincent Tshabalala ntsele ke tla re motswalle wa ka because ntsele ya ngo nna but ne re nani something in common le Vincent. Kore ho tsebeng ha ka Vincent ke mtsibile ka Abdouhai ka boy. Vincent a kholela mogolele ko kholetse ko Petal. Ke jore ko Petal ntsa o ile a motivate ke ntwe ke case ya Joseph Mothuping ka 1977. Ever participate or struggling?
To start with the family background, like I said, you know, he was younger than me, but we were very close in terms of doing things. In the cause in the house, the chores in the house, we were all do it together and then we share some of the things together. And as we grew up, we started training karate together, we grew up together, and I started first, and then I was graduated to be an instructor in karate, and he came through and then said, no, he wanted to train with me every time. So. We did training together, we used to go together to the gym, come back together, sleep together, wake up together, go to school. Up to the time when we never were separated from Alexander High School, that's when they came to the school. And this is where he cut his tooth into politics.
So he had this inquiring mind asking relevant questions. And then obviously when you join, we also ask you, what is your background, why are you interested, and who are you exactly? So that you don't end up with an element where a person is infiltrated, you know. So he then explained that there was this Bethal trial of the PAC leaders, and amongst those people were there was Zephania Mothuping and the others, who after the Soweto uprising in 1977, I think until 1979, they were on trial at the Bethal Magistrate Courts or Bethal Circuit Court, yeah. And so he used, after school, to go to the court and go and listen to the proceedings. And that's how he picked up quite a number of issues. And that's why his inquiring mind started inquiring even more.
A brave young man. In the early years, he became the chairperson of COSAS, Congress of South African Students, and a very dedicated scholar. Although in most cases you find that people who get involved in courses are said not to be serious about education, but Vincent was different.
Kore Vincent ntsale yang go nna but o thole gore always go high ne ba sna problem ka yena ha ke ntsekisa mali yena, and mama kana se sana le that confidence go Vincent, or at least ha ke tsamela le Vincent a ona ntho tse snacks se tlotse halang to a certain extent no hona ni like organization e nngwe ne ba bitsa ditshwantsho tsa rona kore ne ba re motivate ba re concertize re tsamaya re ya kontle like go there was this guy nabitswa ke Harvey and a mobilize batho ba banka dinepe then re scrutinize dinepe tseo tsa teng and or tla invite batho re ba tle ba tlo re fa a lecture on education whatever. So there was this particular day Baliba organized this meeting and go meeting o ne re ya ko tropong and then itse ga ke jetsa mama ka re ya ko tropong ko meeting a se ke ba gola e be Vincent a tla ko hae a convince me wa ka re okay le kana tsama as long as le tsama le bo Vincent ke tswe ra hona two MP le tsa hala.
What I know about Vincent Tshabalala, I happen to be in the same school with him, this very same school where we are, where I am right now, and he was my senior with one class. He was above me with one standard. When he was doing grade 8, which is then standard 6, I was I was doing grade 8 when he was doing grade 9, that's standard 7 for him. But all what happened was I had to see him from the dramas group that they were presenting at school, and he was one of the lively students that we ever had. Debate was one of the students who was top in terms of the debate. Every Friday at the assembly, they would read newspaper, not only him, but there was also another gentleman by the name of Louis Sieko. But Vincent Tshabalala together with Louis Sieko, they would interchange reading the newspaper at the assembly. And we became very interested to keep on looking up to this young man. Above all, in drama groups, I think there's one poem that he liked. The title of the poem was "Ach Sis" by Asinyanyisa.
I met Vincent in 1980 here in this school, where we started with our standard. They call it then not as standard six, yeah. But then I knew him as a schoolmate. We became close, such that even during breaks, I would move with him to his home to have lunch there. You know. In weekends, he would invite me to go to Vincent University to meet some students, those who were belonging to NUSAS then. So we grew very close. And then in 1982, we were doing Standard 8 together. And I was then appointed as a chairperson of COSAS, because I started as an acting secretary. Apparently the secretary was having some problems, so he was not consistent in attending meetings. It was a she, actually, Helen Watt. And then they asked me to be an acting secretary. Then I started taking minutes without that experience, but they explained to me what I should do. Then there was one incident where we had a meeting, and then I was expected to produce the minutes of the last meeting. I did not. Vincent was very upset with me, such that he hit me with a clap, you know. I cried a bit. Actually, I wanted to leave COSAS, you know, because of that, but I decided against it.
Well, I first met Vincent in Alexandra through Dr. Bayer Snodia, and I met him together with a number of other young comrades, which included Paul Mashitile, Albert Bapela, and a number of other people. And myself and my fiancé at that stage, Yancy Lawrence, used to go into the township, and we worked in the underground through the African National Congress. At that stage, Vincent was involved in COSAS, and he was very active in the youth movement in Alexandra. And it was actually evident right from the beginning that he was one of the young people in Alex with great leadership ability. He was a very, very solid young man. And his care, not just for the cause and the issues of the struggle, but also for his family, was all the time evident. So I got to know him for probably about a year and a half. One of the memories I have of that period while he was there is that he went into the Priory Library and he found a songbook and a Bible which belonged to O.R. Tambo. And in the Bible, there were certain verses underlined by O.R., obviously as he was studying the Bible. Because as many of us know, O.R. was a very devoted Christian and Anglican. And St. Peter's Priory was a very important place for him during the time that he still lived in South Africa. And I remember how much Vincent treasured that Bible and that songbook. Then towards the end of a period of about 7 days, we managed to have established what had to be done to take Vincent and his group out of the country. And we had arranged with a comrade that specially came in from across Botswana to take them across. And I remember the evening when we had to make the arrangements and let them go, Vincent said to me, "Before I go, can you just take me in your car to a public telephone booth?" And I was very reluctant because I didn't want him to make phone calls. Any phone call, it's always possible somewhere to be traced. But he insisted. So we went to a public telephone booth and he made a phone call. I stood away, and afterwards when he came back, I said to him, "I hope it's okay." He said, "No, I just had to phone my mum and tell her that I'm going." And I think that was also, again, characteristic of who Vincent is, that he was the kind of person who wasn't just leaving and not feeling what it meant. He realized also how it was going to hurt and also disturb his mum. And he was the kind of young man, because that was really what he was, who cared about his elders and who cared about his mum. We later on got a report that the whole group successfully managed to cross the Botswana border. They stayed for a while in Botswana and then they moved on. The last I heard was that they were in Angola.
And I must say that I was very fortunate, you know, to have lived amongst giants like Vincent and others within that plateau that I trained. You see, there was Vincent, there was Bimbo, who also perished, you know, in Cape Town. There was something unique about Vincent. His level, you know, of discipline. He was not, you know, a forward person, right? But he would always, you know, ensure that whenever the work has to be carried out, he would be in the forefront and he would ensure that, you know, that task is carried out to the latter, you know. And he was not only, you know, a man of action, but he was an analyst as well, you know. I've spent quite a number of, you know, occasions, you know, in the camp, you know, discussing with him, you know. You know, they came being this very large group, which came, you know, in the early 80s, you know, when the country was on a boil, you know. And they were all very energetic, you know, all very angry, you know. And it was one's responsibility to ensure that, you know, that anger, you know, gets channeled, you know, to serve the purpose, you know, that brought them to exile, you know. That they should, you know, train to use weapons of war. And integrated with that, you know, was the fact that they should understand, you know, the politics of the movement. They should understand, you know, their calling, that the objective was not only to unleash vengeance, you know, when they come back into the country, but, you know, was to be involved in systematic struggles of the people, you know, ensure that, you know, they, whatever steps they take, you know, in terms of using their weapons of war, would be, you know, effective steps, you know, that would assist, you know, to bring, you know, the day of liberation, you know, nearer. So, you see, there was that anger, and it was my, it was one's role at that point in time to ensure that this anger, you know, is channeled, you know, that this energy is channeled, you know, to serve the purpose of the liberation of our country. Vincent was that sort of person, you know, very intense, you know, and non-assuming for that matter, you know. You wouldn't think that where he comes from, he was a leader, you know, because he was just amongst the people. But it was so easy to pick him out, you know, as a giant, you know, whenever, you know, you're addressing the plateau, right? I've had a number of discussions with him. I used to like, you know, to call him to my dwelling, you know. What used to happen there, you know, we're living under real bushes, you know, in Angola. We were living in dugouts, you know, and we used to call those dugouts dwellings, right? I used to call him to my dwelling and discuss with him. And he had a very analytic mind. He came to understand, you know, that anger alone is not enough when we're fighting, you know, the sort of formidable enemy that we're fighting. He knew that the enemy was, you know, not indestructible, but he knew that for us to be able to destroy that enemy, would have to be very systematic, would have to, you know, mobilize people, would have to, you know, ensure that, you know, everybody, you know, sings our song, you know, when we march to freedom. So Vincent was that sort of a person. And then as the commissar of the platoon, you know, I used to do what is called characterization. It was my role again to look at individuals, you know, and give my view of those individuals. And I always, you know, pointed out that Vincent was the sort of person who was a leader, you know, who who was a leader who listened to people. And once the decision has been taken, you know, after discussions were conducted, you know, he would be in the forefront, you know, of implementing those decisions. And he would always make sure, you know, that somebody is at the same level, you know, to implement such decisions. When I hear that Vincent had, you know, had perished, and honorably so, you know, it was a very emotional moment for me. I really felt bad about the loss of such an intelligent, you know, a young man. And also, you know, the closeness that I had forged with him, you know, was another issue.
And then I remember one morning, a couple of years after I was already in prison, we had a service where the prisoners, prison authorities allowed us to listen to one news item, one news bulletin a day, early in the morning. And I remember I was standing right in front of the gate waiting for the warders to come and open my cell. And we listened to the 7 o'clock news bulletin, and it announced that a African National Congress terrorist with the name of Vincent Tshabalala was shot dead in Alexandra. That was the first time that I heard that Vincent had returned to South Africa. And I went ice cold. I just couldn't believe that someone of Vincent's abilities, someone of Vincent's courage, had been killed by the apartheid regime. And I must say, for that day, and probably for many days afterward, it was like a dark cloud hanging over me. I couldn't talk to many people except some of my own comrades. I couldn't find out all the details of what happened. The only bit of news I had was Vincent was shot dead in Alex.
But we always remembered him as somebody who has always been committed to education. Hence, after his death, we decided that as a way to honor him, we needed to focus on education. The birth of the Vincent Tshabalala Education Trust came as a result of paying tribute to him.
As a person who came from a disadvantaged background, I couldn't have had the opportunity of going to a tertiary life and viewing what happens in tertiary. Vincent Tshabalala Trust Fund, it's a great cause, that's what I can say. It helps most people who are disadvantaged to get on with their lives. Because coming to think about it, if it wasn't for the Vincent Tshabalala, there would be approximately, how many students are we gonna? It's 5. Again, the same year, 5 students would be go high, sitting and doing nothing. But thanks to the Vincent Tshabalala, it's taking up 5 students per year, which is a very great number, if I can say that. It's a great number. And yeah, it's a good cause. Honestly, it's not, it is a good cause.
Yeah, especially as a black child, you know, we have to appreciate whatever little thing that you have, or whatever little thing that you get. I can't say I complain. I can say it did help me a lot. I do appreciate what it did. Especially from a township like Alex. You know Alex, you know, a lot of things are happening there. So things like this and Tshabalala, they really appreciate such things. And it mustn't be like only to certain learners who have exam trick and come to varsity, but also to learners from, you know, grade 10, grade, because I think that's where Bastatan, like, the, you know, another level of a bit of young adult, that's when most of people face a lot of things. Whereas people face things after matric. You know, it's a different thing.
So thanks to the Vincent Tshabalala, it spotted me from grade 12, paid for my fees, and thanks to them, that's how I got the other buzzer. Yeah.
Also what we do, once students are accepted, we also get them to do community work. So students who are on the Vincent Tshabalala education trust bursaries, they do work over weekends in the community. So they come back to Alex, they teach other students who are still doing their matric, because we believe that this trust must not only to be about to assist students to have skills and a better education, but also to be better community leaders. There must be people who understand that you are a student, but at the same time, you belong to a community. So they must come back to the community and assist the community to develop. They must have that sense of responsibility.